Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial. Today we are going to learn how to recreate this morphing animation using Linearity Move. Let's get started. When I first open the app, I'm going to see the home screen. To create a new document, I click the plus button. Here, I can pick the resolution of my new document or import an existing file. I can import a file from Curve, Linearity's design tool, or connect to Figma and import a design from there. I'm going to select this Curve file and hit the import button to enter the scene builder panel. Here, I can see as many artboards as there are on my design file. I simply select and drag one of the artboards to the scene builder line at the bottom of the panel. I can also change the duration of the scene from here. When I am done, I click the import button. I've created four scenes and imported all the assets for each layout. I double click on the last scene. In this space, I have six shapes. In the top row, I have a circle, a flower, and a star. These shapes all have 16 points each. At the bottom row, I have a diamond, a circle, and a star. These shapes all have 8 points each. This is very important. To have the best effect using morphing, all the shapes need to have the same number of points. I switch to design mode. I reposition and center the shapes on the top row. Then, I select the morph button from the top right menu. I repeat the same steps for the shapes at the bottom row. This time, I use a shortcut to apply the morph animation. I press the M key on my keyboard and the job is done. I copy and paste the single keyframes to repeat the animation with the back and forth effect. I can use morphing as a transition for different properties: shape, opacity, position, rotation, and fill color. In this second example, I select all the rectangles. I align them at the center and I press M on my keyboard. To make this animation more interesting, I am selecting the animation bars and I change the timing from natural to step. I select the animation bars and copy and paste them to repeat the animation another time. I can also morph to create a transition between multiple properties. I switch to design mode and position all the elements at the center of the canvas. I select the two lines of text and press the M key. Then I select the two rectangles and press the M key again. And with that, I've created a hover effect for this button. I copy and paste the keyframes along the timeline to have a switch on and off effect. To add my animations to the main scene, I double click the last scene and I select the object I want to transfer. I press Command C to copy, I go back to the main scene and I press Command V to paste. I switch to design mode to reposition my animated shape. Then I position the image on top of it and I right click to create a mask with the animated shape. I repeat the same steps for the other elements. I add the second animated shape and I resize it. I add the colored rectangle and I change the size to 500 pixels. I align it to the bottom right corner and I right click to send it to the back. Add the button and then reposition it to replace the static one. I switch back to animate mode. I select the cursor and I move it on top of the button. I select the button's rectangle and I add a tap animation from the preset library on the left. Then I copy and paste keyframes to the end of the timeline to move the cursor back to its previous position. To complete this animation, I press the pin button to quickly determine the start and end point of my next animation. I select all the text layers with details of the event. I move the text down by pressing the down arrow 3 times and I lower the opacity to 0%. I move the highlighted segment to the end of the timeline. I select the same text layers and move them up by pressing the top arrow 3 times and I lower the opacity to 0%. My animation is complete. So it is time to delete the other scenes from the project timeline. When I'm ready, I can export my animation by clicking File on the top left corner and select Export. Here, I can preview my animation one last time before exporting it. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you found this tutorial useful. You can learn more about Linearity Move and animation from the Learn tab on the home screen. Let's bring our stories to life with Linearity Move.